Big changes are coming at the State Commerce Department. How will a revamped agency help create jobs? The new Commerce Secretary explains today on Upfront.
I think this corporation in July is going to be a stark contrast from where commerce was over the last couple of years.
Reince Priebus gets down to business at the Republican National Committee. Today, how he plans to help win Wisconsin for the GOP in 2012.
The president's map does not work out without Wisconsin being blue.
And a fan creates a special song for Congressman Paul Ryan. It's all this week on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Gouchet.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. You can almost feel it. You know, the glow that comes with basking in the national spotlight. Wisconsin has had more than its fair share of attention in just the past few days. The Packers punched their ticket to the Super Bowl by beating their hated rivals, the Bears, but that's football. This is a show about politics, and we're making news in that arena, too. Wisconsin Congressman Paul Ryan delivered the Republican response to the State of the Union speech Tuesday night. President Obama visited the green energy company Orion in Manitowoc the day after his speech. And January began with State Republican Party Chairman Reince Priebus being elected chairman of the Republican National Committee. Wisconsin, it seems, is where the action is, and that may not be an accident. Here to help us explain why is the new head of the Republican Party, Reince Priebus, who joins us on the satellite from Washington. Chairman Priebus, thanks very much for being with us today.
Well, Mike, it's great to be back on your show. Little different circumstances,
yeah.
but a real pleasure nonetheless.
I just suggested a premise that says that some of the attention being paid to Wisconsin politics and politicians in recent weeks says something pretty substantial about the role Wisconsin will play in 2012. Do you agree with that?
Well, absolutely. Obviously, Wisconsin will be a battleground state once again in 2012. There's no doubt about it, Mike. Obviously, the president came to Wisconsin immediately after the State of the Union address. The president's map does not work out without Wisconsin being blue. But I believe that Wisconsin will stay red. I think you saw what happens when the president had come to Wisconsin, I don't know how many times, maybe six or seven times over the past year in order to get Wisconsin in the column for Tom Barrett and Russ Feingold. The issues were laid out crystal clear, Mike, and the people in Wisconsin said no, and they went Republican, they went conservative. I think essentially voters in Wisconsin are fiscal conservatives. Those are the issues. And just so well articulated by our great Congressman Paul Ryan in the response. So I think that's where the people in Wisconsin will be. But nonetheless, Wisconsin will be a battleground state in 2012.
So can we go as far as to say, as Wisconsin goes, so goes the nation, or at least so goes the Midwest?
Well, I think I don't think that's too far off. I think Wisconsin is certainly a microcosm of the rest of the country. I do think the fiscal issues are what's driving the agenda right now around the country, obviously. And those issues will be spelled out very clearly in these battleground states like Wisconsin. And given the choice, given the very clear choice between higher taxes, more spending, crushing deficits, and a position of not just lower taxes, but less spending, cutting spending back to 2008 or previous levels, in order to truly get a handle on where our deficits are going in this country. I think when you lay out those stark contrasts, the people in Wisconsin and the people all throughout the country will choose the Republican candidates.
I want to talk to you for a few minutes about how your new job is going. And I really haven't seen that many television interviews with you. Is that intentional? Will you be keeping a lower profile than your predecessor, Michael Steele?
Well, my view on the media is, and certainly we've done plenty of it, and we'll continue to do appearances where appropriate and where necessary. If I'm not advancing a serious Republican position or platform, or if I'm not actually helping somebody get elected, then my personal opinion is that I probably have other things to do, like raise money and save our financial condition here at the RNC, or meet with folks that are on the ground in the states, state chairman, to make sure that we can put competitive races on the ballot. If I'm not doing those things, then probably running around cable TV shows is probably not the best thing and best place for me to be. So that's where my focus is right now, Mike. I've been meeting with finance chairman all throughout the country, former finance chairman, former RNC chairman. I need to do the blocking and tackling necessary in this building to do the job. We have a financial condition here where, I mean, quite frankly, the train is off the rails. And so I need to fix the building here at the RNC in Washington first before we spend too much time outside the building on cable news shows. So I think it's really fundamental to rebuild the trust of our donors, to rebuild the trust of our grassroots, that we have a functional, operational RNC. And that's my first job here, Mike, and that's what I have to do. I have to earn that trust, and I have to work to earn that trust. And so that's where my focus is, and certainly over time, there'll be plenty of time for television and more time for print media. That will come. But immediately, the money and getting the trust back for the RNC is where my focus must be, and that's what I'm committed to doing.
Well, let's pursue a couple of those points. You walked into a situation where, by public estimates, the party's about $20 million in debt, so you've got to take care of that. You also, as you touched on, have to repair relationships. And a lot of the big donors took their money elsewhere in the last election cycle. They went to new Republican groups instead of giving money to the Republican National Committee. What are you doing to repair those relationships with the big donors?
Well, for one thing, I'm calling them. And
that
that's
wasn't
the first
being
step,
done?
Is to simply call those. Well, in many cases, I've called numerous major donors, and some people have told me that they'd never received a phone call. So that's the first step. The second step is, I think that for whatever reason, fair, unfair, or a combination of the two, a lot of these major donors just didn't feel comfortable giving to the RNC. And I think they feel more comfortable now than they did before. I think in having those conversations and talking about how we're going to fix the financial condition here at the RNC, what we're going to do to restore trust, how we're going to build up the rest of the team around us, and how we're going to be a little less of self and a little bit more of everybody else, those are the things that donors want to talk about, and they're excited about it. We had, Mike, on Tuesday, the biggest grouping of former national finance chairs at the RNC than has ever been done before. And if you read the press accounts of people like Mel Sembler, Sam Fox, Al Hoffman, Ron Weiser, these folks came together throughout the entire country, flew into Washington, D.C. on 5 days' notice to work to figure out how to put that the finances back on their shoulders, to help lead the way, to help fix the problem. That's what we're focused on, and that's what we're doing. And I think it starts with trust, and those are the things that I hope that I could convince those donors of, that they can trust me, that they can trust the RNC, and that's where it starts. It starts here in the building, and we're off to a great start.
I've got just a few seconds left, and I want to end this on a lighthearted note. Jon Stewart, Stephen Colbert, David Letterman, they've all had fun with your name. How do you feel about that? Will you be appearing on any of their shows in the near future?
Well, who knows? I mean, I doubt it, but to me, how do I feel about it? I think most of it's pretty hilarious. So, you get used to it, obviously, growing up and waiting for that first day of school, waiting for your name to be read by the teacher. But for the most part, I think it's hilarious. And as you know, Mike, I do have an odd name, but I'm about as normal as they get. So people will figure that out. But in the meantime, I'm having a lot of fun with it.
Let me tell you, Goucher is not a household name either. So I can kind of understand. I empathize a little bit on that front. Reince Priebus, the new chair of the Republican National Committee, we appreciate your time. Thanks very much for being with us today.
Great to be back, Mike.
And now for something completely different, the Commerce Department as a public-private agency. Just how is this going to work? We'll talk about it next on Upfront.
More money troubles at the Capitol. The emergency action that might be needed when Upfront continues.